In today's video, I will explain anatomy of deltoid. I will explain its origin, insertion, and function. This is profile view and slightly superior view. This is deltoid. This is very big shoulder muscles. Let me explain its origin first. If you divide deltoid, you can divide deltoid to three parts. Anterior part, middle part, and posterior part. Anterior, middle, and posterior part. What is this part? This posterior part attaches to scapula. This part is spinal scapula. Spine of scapula. This kind of a bony ridge on scapula. How about middle fiber? Middle fiber attaches flat surface of scapula. This is acromion. Acromion. Then let's go to anterior part. It attaches to lateral part of clavicle. Look at that. Its origin is very, very wide. Spinal scapula, acromion, and lateral part of clavicle. Origin is very, very wide. Let's go to insertion. Compared to origin, insertion is very narrow. It's very pointy. This is it. This yellow part is insertion. This is deltoid tuberosity. That's it. Origin is basically scapula and clavicle. Insertion is deltoid tuberosity. That's it. Easy, right? Now let's go to function of deltoid. I said you can divide deltoid to three parts. Anterior fiber, middle fiber, and posterior fiber. Then all three fibers can do one movement. That is shoulder abduction. Abduction. Abduction is you raise arm sideways. This is shoulder abduction. By the way, also scapula can do abduction, but that is different. This is shoulder abduction, okay? Shoulder abduction and scapula abduction is completely different movement. Deltoid does shoulder abduction, okay? This differentiation is very, very important. All right, abduction is the common movement that all three fibers can do. Mainly, middle fiber does shoulder abduction. How about anterior fiber and posterior fiber? These guys can do so many movements. Let's focus on anterior fiber first. Alright, anterior fiber. As name of fiber suggests, this fiber is on anterior part of shoulder. It's close to chest. Thus, when this part contracts, that can bring shoulder this way. What kind of movement is that? One movement is shoulder flexion. Shoulder flexion. You raise arm for forward way. This is shoulder flexion. Many more movements. One more movement is internal rotation. Internal rotation. Then one more movement. Alright, when you bring arm like 90 degrees, then you cross arm this way. It's like this movement. It's like dumbbell fly movement. This is horizontal adduction. Horizontal adduction. Again, this is like dumbbell fly movement. Oh my gosh, three movements. Shoulder flexion, shoulder internal rotation, and horizontal adduction. Simple way is anterior fiber is on anterior part. What happens when this fiber contracts? That basically brings shoulder for anterior direction. Flexion and internal rotation. Internal rotation is kind of anterior direction, right? And horizontal adduction, kind of dumbbell fly movement. You move shoulder anteriorly, right? Anterior fiber basically brings shoulder for anterior way. Very, very simple. Then let's go to posterior fiber. Again, posterior fiber is this part. It's slightly hard to see. Imagine this is posterior fiber. What can posterior fiber do? Actually, it's completely opposite function from anterior fiber. Again, what is functions of anterior fiber? Flexion, internal rotation, and horizontal adduction, right? Posterior fiber does completely opposite. When posterior fiber contracts, that brings shoulder to posterior way. Do you remember? Anterior fiber brings shoulder to anterior way. What is function of posterior fiber? Let's see. Shoulder extension. Extension, opposite from flexion, right? External rotation. Opposite from internal rotation, right? Then, what is opposition of horizontal adduction? That is horizontal abduction. Horizontal abduction is opposite movement compared to dumbbell fly. You kind of open up your chest. You bring shoulder this way. This is horizontal abduction. Oh my gosh, deltoid can do so many things. What is common function? That is shoulder abduction, right? Shoulder abduction, that's main function. Anterior fiber, flexion, internal rotation, horizontal abduction. Posterior fiber, extension, external rotation, and horizontal abduction. Now, anterior fiber and posterior fiber can do one more movement in certain situation. What is that? All right, this is anterior view. What is the last movement? That is shoulder adduction. But wait a minute. Main function of deltoid is shoulder abduction. How come that can do shoulder adduction? That is very good question. Anterior fiber and posterior fiber do shoulder adduction in certain angle of shoulder joint. Okay, about less than 60 degrees of shoulder abduction, 60 degrees abduction, anterior fiber and posterior fiber do shoulder adduction. Why is that? This is where your shoulder joint is. And axis of movement is about here, about center of humerus, right? Imagine this is axis of movement. Let's go back to previous picture. This is deltoid, and this is axis of shoulder joint. Again, this is deltoid, axis of movement. Imagine, deltoid covers shoulder joint like this. And part of anterior fiber is kind of below angle of joint. So when shoulder is less than 60 degrees abduction position, this contraction of anterior fiber brings shoulder to adduction. It's not very powerful shoulder adductor, but this is a biomechanics of shoulder movement. I didn't know this until I looked up anatomy book carefully. This is very interesting thing. And also, posterior fiber does adduction for same reason. Part of posterior fiber is kind of below the axis of movement. And this contraction brings shoulder to adduction position. And how much degree? It's less than 60 degrees. This is very interesting thing to know. That said, deltoid basically does every single movement of shoulder joint. Think about it. Flexion, extension, internal rotation, external rotation, of course, abduction, horizontal abduction, and shoulder adduction. Every movement. Deltoid does every single movement of shoulder joint. Oh my gosh, this is incredible. This is so important muscle for shoulder movement. Particularly shoulder adduction. Oh my gosh, this is so important. So interesting thing to know. It was surprising news for me personally. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.